Hi everyone, I hope you guys are doing amazing. Now this video is about five remedies. Out of these five, four would be the home remedies that you can use for relieving your back pain. Why I am making this video all of a sudden is just because I am myself experiencing some back pain and discomfort, and I know it is a problem for most of us and it happens every now and then, so I thought why not to share it with you. So let's get started and see what are the things that you can do. And please, these are not in any rank, or these are just randomly. You can just pick the one that suits you. These are tried and tested, so yeah, you can rely on it, but everything completely depends on your body. So please use these methods as per the comfort of your own body. Okay, so the first one is you can use heat and cold pads. Now, cold pads are usually recommended immediately after the injury. So for example, you have just experienced a back pain. Probably you were lifting something or you were just trying to get up and it happens. You just experienced something, and then you can use a cold pad because it can numb that area. It can, you know, relieve the pain and it will help you in relaxing. But say for instance it's been a day or so, and then cold pad is not recommended, then heating baths are recommended because they just give you they just relax your muscles. And personally, I'm a big fan of heating pads because whenever I have back pain, more than the heating belt, I like that heating pad bottle. I just use that bottle and then it gives me a lot of relief. And if you think your skin is too sensitive, then do not place the bottle directly here. Then you can probably wrap your bottle in a cotton cloth, or and then you can put it here so that it doesn't put pressure or anything negative on your skin. So that's one. Number two would be, well, if you're experiencing, then you can do certain exercises, certain stretching, and it is always good. I know there are certain back pains wherein you can barely move. So for instance, my situation here, I might not be able to sit, in a single position for continuously for like say 5-10 minutes. So I have to keep on moving or shifting. There could be somewhere and you can barely get up, right? But then there are certain exercises that I'll just tell you. And those, if you think your body allows, you can do those exercises and it will actually relieve your pain, and it will give you... I would say it will give you a lot of relief and you will feel good about it. So take a look at these exercises. Yeah, so when basically you touch your toes and you stretch your hamstrings, so you loosen the muscles in your lower back. Plus, please make sure if you cannot bend because of the pain, do not do it. Do not push yourself. Just do it when if you can comfortably do, and do not touch your toes completely. So for instance, say if you cannot touch your toes completely, but if you think like probably bending like this also helps, then just do it. So do till the amount you feel it is comfortable. Do not push yourself. Do not overdo anything because I don't want you to worsen your situation thinking that this might help you. So please do not push yourself. Then you can do the cobra pose wherein you need to lie on your stomach and then heads up and then your hands like this, and it also relaxes your body. Again, I'm saying it, please do it only if your body allows. The back pains can be different, upper back, lower back, and then depending on where the pain is, the extent of pain. So please, it's a humble request, only do it if your body allows. Third stretch that you can do is a cat-cow pose. That also helps in relieving back pain. And the fourth one is child pose. So these are the stretching that you can do, or you can feel whichever way you are bending and you're feeling right. Just stretching your body also helps you in relieving pain. So yeah. Okay, so moving on to the third one. Third one is you can do this in addition to the rest of the remedies. You can have hot milk with turmeric, haldi, just a little bit of it, and then you can just boil it. And once the, let's say you took one glass of milk and you put in turmeric in it, and then just make sure that it boils and it remains till, let's say, 3/4, a little more than half. And then you can drink it, one obviously not hot, just let it cool down a bit, and once it is warm and you think you can drink it, just drink it, because it relieves a lot of your pain from inside your body. You can do this in addition to the other remedies. So that's number three. Number four is massaging. Now you can either massage with any specific oil that you have, but one that always works for me is you just need to take mustard oil, sarso ka tel. You just need to make sure that you heat it up, and you then add garlic to it, and then you can add carom seeds, ajwain, and then just let it settle for some time. And you need to apply it on the impacted area and make sure that the oil doesn't get, I mean, it should be warm, not very hot, and it should not be cold. It should be little more than warm and just little less than hot. Just see the amount that your body can handle, and also the one who's applying, because they have to dip their fingers and then apply it. And finally, you can just take painkillers. I know it is, you have to take painkillers when there are situations, but when you do take painkillers and when you do all these things, it definitely helps you. So like I said, not all are home remedies, except one, four are the home remedies, then you can use them. Personally tried and tested many a times, and this can help you in relieving your back pain. I hope the video was helpful and informational, and have a great day, and I'll be back with another video. Bye.